Small print shops may not have access to precise color measurement tools to meet customers' need for accurate colors of logos and graphics. The Express Color Wizard helps you to create print modes and aids you in reproducing your customers' specific color needs within the Digital Factory software. The Express Color Wizard is available for the Universal Controller Driver, or UCD, and other select DTF printers. To use the Color Wizard, make sure you are in a queue for the UCD. Then go to the Device menu and select Manage Print Modes. Select a print mode in the list in the lower half of the manager. With a print mode selected, the Express Color Setup icon will become active at the top right of the dialog. Click the icon and in the resulting dialog, give the new print mode a name, and then click OK. The initial dialog states the wizard's purpose to help in setting up a print mode that will produce satisfactory results, allowing the user to start printing as quickly and smoothly as possible. Click Next. The next dialog asks if the user would like to set the maximum white ink. Select No if you wish to skip setting your max white and click Next. If you wish to set the maximum white ink, with Yes selected, click Next. This will open the page size dialog. First, you will set the page size of your print bed. For this example, I'm using A4, page size. Next, we need to select the graphic that be used for the print sample. The suggested graphic is a good option as it creates a simple chart of increasing levels of white underbase ink levels. Now, I will set the size I would like to print the graphic. This way, I can set the number of samples on the page, giving me more variations of white ink values to choose from. With everything set on this page, click Next. This next dialog has the printer options. These are usually left as the default, unless there is a custom value you would like to use. With the default value set, click Next. The variable dot setup dialog will now appear. The options are leaving it as already set with the original settings in the print mode, large dots only, which is recommended, medium and large dots, and lastly, small, medium, and large dots. The option of color ink levels on the white chart is to set the amount of ink that will be used on the white ink. You have the values of 20, 40, 60, 80, and 100 from the drop-down list. With these values assigned, click Next. The dialog for maximum white appears. This is where the minimum and maximum values of white ink are set, as well as the increment of change. Here, I will leave the value set with minimum value to 50%, the maximum value to 100%, and set the increments to 10% to get a good range of white underbase. Now, click Print Max White Ink Chart. You will see that 6 jobs with white ink from 50% to 100% have been created in the queue.
Print the samples by selecting any of the jobs, right-click and select Print or select the print icon above. Once the print is complete, prepare it with powder and press the chart onto the target media that you plan on using for your final job.
After viewing the printed results and comparing the color and vibrance of the different jobs, go back to the Set Maximum Wizard and in the field representing the preferred white ink percentage on the bottom right, enter the chosen value. In this case, a value of 60% had the best results. Click Next.
You are now in the final dialog.
This is where you set the white under black. You have 3 options. First option is the recommended settings established for DTF and DTG printers. The second option is best for UV printers, and the third option allows you to set your own custom settings, but it is not recommended since the first 2 options are based on many years of development. After you have decided on the amount of white under black, click Finish. This brings you to the Print Ink Limits dialog. To proceed through the process, you will need to print out the ink charts provided. To be as accurate as possible, you should print onto the media you plan on printing to during production. If you will be printing to a shirt, then you should print the color charts onto a sample of the same fabric.
Click Next.
You are now in the Select Preferred Chart dialog. Look at the print results and decide which chart visually looks the best and does not have any ink flooding, banding, or streaking. Click on the drop-down list and select which value looked the best. For this example, we will choose G1 and then click Next. This brings you to the Select Max Ink dialog. This is where you will select the value in the black swatches before you see any flooding. For this example, the best value was 320, and then click Next. You are now in the Select Best Color profile dialog.
Set your page size and you have a choice to print a recommended image which has a good range of print scenarios.
But if you are more concerned with the colors in the specific image, you can import the image of your print job. You can set the size of the image that you will be printing to have as many on a page while remaining at a size that can be analyzed for color accuracy. We will leave this at the default size. Lastly, click on the Print Image with All Print-A-Color Profiles button at the bottom. This will create printouts of 6 color profiles, 1 to 6. Again, print the logo and press on to the target media, which is a shirt. Now decide which profile has the best color result when comparing to the original logo. Each profile will be numbered 1 to 6. Click Next to take you to the dialog to select the color print profile. Click on the drop-down and you will see an option for each color profile. Select the profile that has the brightest, punchiest, or most accurate colors from the samples. In this example, the best profile is number 3. Select Profile 3 from the drop-down list and click Next. You are now in a dialog that allows you to make color adjustments if you want.
To continue with Color Adjust, tick the Enable box and you can now make your adjustments.
If you would like to have the colors a little more saturated, increase the amount of saturation by dragging the saturation marker to the right to increase the saturation value. The yellows need to be a little darker. Drag the yellow marker to the right to darken the yellows. There are 3 rendering intents to choose from at the bottom: Default, Photo, and Graphics. Default uses the rendering intent of the color profile. We suggest using this option if the current profile produces satisfactory results. The photo option is used for prints that will contain many gradients or skin tones. It will help maintain the gradations and prevent them from appearing oversaturated. Finally, the graphic option is recommended when the colors in the selected profile need to be more vivid. We want the colors to pop, so the graphic option will be selected. Print this example with the color adjustments to be sure these settings give you desirable results. You can print this several times over as you tweak the colors until you have the cue and print mode to where you have successful results. You can start over and reset all the changes back to before anything was adjusted by clicking the reset button. Click Next, and the wizard will apply the adjustment to the print mode of the cue. The last dialog is more for an administration purpose, where you name your ink set, category, media manufacturer, and media description so you have a little background next time you look at this profile.
Click Next to save the print mode to the queue. Finally, click Finish to close the dialog.
This print mode will now be applied to any job added to this queue.
Thanks for watching. If this video helped you, hit the like button, and if you have any questions, please reach out to us at any time. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos covering digital factory products.